guys, so I'm just going to put a bit of sanding sealer on this. This is a bit of Sapele that I've turned. I've sanded to 320 grit. I'm going to use a sanding sealer, and then I'm going to go over with a friction polish. So if you haven't already, I've used both the Liberon and the Chestnut products sanding sealer. At the moment I'm trialling out the Liberon spirit sanding sealer. I'll show you how this works with the Chestnut products, friction polish. Recommended that you use both Chestnut products for your pieces. But yeah, you basically you just want to. This is what I do. So you just want to put it on a bit of tissue paper. Make sure it's all covered. There's a few questions with sanding sealer. So it was how many coats do you have to apply? That was one of them. The answer is only one because it seals it, and that's it. There's no point in adding more sealer. It just doesn't do anything. It just sits on top. So all I'm doing here, I've just added a little bit extra because I've missed some areas. Make sure it's all covered. And that is it. So my finial only goes up to here. This is going to be the base of it, and it will obviously sand up. So once that's done, you want to sand back with the highest grit of what you've done previously. So mine was 320, so I'm just going to zoom out. And sand back to 320 again. So just like that, what you can see on here, there's a slight film of polish on there. You can see the shimmer. So rather than it just being like a sawdust on this side here, this is the side that I've used to activate the sanding sealer. And if it'll focus in, see just a little shine. That's the actual sanding sealer itself. So that's what you want to look for. Once you get the shine on the paper, you don't want to go too mad, you know, it's just taking off that top bit. With both products, I'm going to be using the Chestnut friction polish on this one. Make sure you give them all a good shake, especially the sanding sealer. Otherwise you'll just get the sanding part of the base, as you've seen. So make sure you do it. Get a good coverage. I'm just going to use this much, so it's one splurge of polish, and this will require heat, so just put a little bit of friction on there, a little bit of pressure, sorry, just to get the friction. There you have it, the finished finial. I'll pot this off and give you a close up. So here's the finished finial. It's just made out of Sapele. Nothing major, you know, it's no walnut or anything like that. I've put a little spigot on here, just so that when you do put it into a lid or something, you can fit that in. It just gives it a little bit more to hold on to.